Chilan, today we will learn a new chapter from your English textbook. The title is Thieves at Work. It is written by Cheryl Ruff. This is a short graphic story. So short graphic story means it's a story with pictures. This is about two children, Rajiv and Santhya, helping their grandfather to arrange a surprise gift for grandma for her 40th wedding anniversary. Let's read ahead to see how the children surprised their grandma. Every day started the same way in Mehra household, with Rajiv and Sandhya eating breakfast with their parents and grandparents, then rushing off to school while their parents hurried to work. But with their grandpa around, they could never tell what was in store for them. So this para speaks about the daily routine in Mehra's house. Every day, the children would have their breakfast together with parents and grandparents and rush to school while their parents to their workplace. But they had an interesting grandpa, and you would never know what plans he made to surprise everyone at home. Meet me in the shed at 3. I have a plan. Oh no, I hope Grandpa doesn't have some impossible task for us. Another of Grandpa's plans. Now what? So now, as the children were going out to school, he stopped them and asked them to meet him in the shed at 3 in the evening. He also said that he had a plan. Now both the children were thinking in their mind what plans Grandpa would have. Rajiv and Santhya had often participated in Grandpa's plans and were wary. I hope it's not like his make our own kites for Sankranti plan. Don't be mean, that was fun. Fun for you. All you did was select the colors. Now on the way to school, in the bus, children are discussing about what would be the plan of Grandpa. So Rajiv says that it should not be like the plan that he had on Sankranti, like making their own kites. So it was difficult for him. He had to make the kite. Now the girl says that it was fun. She enjoyed making kites. But boy actually told her that what she did was only to select the colors, but the making of the kite was done by her. The Protect the Trees in the Neighborhood project was better. Where Grandpa and I dug and fixed wire mesh and you hung the signboards. So here the girl is telling the boy that before the project that Grandpa made, Protect the Trees, that was better. The plan that he made was better. So here the boy is teaching her, telling that all the work was done by himself and Grandpa, and what she did was only to hang the pictures or signboards. That afternoon, the children met Grandpa in the shed. He said, "This is an emergency, kids. We have just a few days to pull a major heist." What? "Oh, Grandpa, who are you planning to rob?" "Your grandma." "What? We don't understand." "Our 40th anniversary is coming up and I have had a brainwave." "Oh, is that why?" "Shh, don't give the game away." So as it was told, the children met their grandpa in the shed at 3 p.m. and he told them that what he was going to was very important, going to say was very important, very emergency, and they had to perform a major heist. Heist means robbery. So children got puzzled and they asked him who he was planning to rob. Then he said that it was their grandma. Then they said the reason why they said that they did not understand why they had to rob grandma. Then he said that their 40th anniversary was coming and he had an idea of how to celebrate or how to give a surprise, and the children agreed to that. "I gave your grandma a necklace on our first anniversary and she loved it. Now I want you to steal it from her jewelry box and give it to me. Grandma, sorry, Grandpa, are you being an old Scrooge? Are you going to give it to her again and hope that she doesn't remember? My dear girl, is that what you think of your favorite grandfather? If you are not being a Scrooge, then why, Grandpa? The old necklace had glass beads, but Grandma loved the design so much that I want to make an identical one with real rubies. You know, rubies for our 40th anniversary. Oh, Grandpa, that's so sweet. So Grandpa told his plans to the children. He told that on their first anniversary, he had gifted a necklace to his wife, and he's asking the children to steal that now and give it to him. And the children are actually puzzled to hear that, because he actually wants to give a gift on her 40th wedding anniversary, and now he is going to steal what he had given in the first anniversary. So they called him a Scrooge. Scrooge means a stingy person, because he did not want to give new one, so he is trying to give the old one. That's what the children thought. So he said that his idea was something different. No, so he wants to make an identical one with real rubies. He wanted to give actually rubies or ruby necklace for her on her 40th anniversary. The children agreed to that. A moment ago, I was a Scrooge. Well, it doesn't matter. Get to work. Go. Plan it out. Wait, Grandpa. You said you had a plan. My plan is to have the necklace copied. Your plan is how to get it. The children found themselves outside the shed. Actually, it's not so tough. Just open grandma's cupboard and take the necklace. Sure, it's easy. Get her cupboard keys from her. Find where her jewelry is kept in the cupboard and pick out the necklace. Easy as pie. Apart from the fact that we have to steal it, this is not a bad anniversary gift. Remember the time grandpa made grandma a rocking chair and it collapsed and grandma got stuck? And when he gave her the jack in the box with his picture on the face of the jack, and it flew off the box and hit her on the cheek. So the children agreed to his idea, and they said that they would help him steal the necklace that he had given her on her first marriage anniversary. Now, outside the shed, the children were discussing that the work is going to be easy. They also remembered about that particular rocking chair that he had gifted her on one of the anniversaries, and grandma getting collapsed chair, or no, grandma got stuck up in the chair when the chair collapsed. They also remembered an occasion when grandpa gave grandma a jack in the box which had his picture on the face of the jack, and as she opened the box it flew off and hit her on the cheek.